In this video, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite topics, digestion, and I'm going to show you how to improve the way you both break down and absorb your food. Digestion is the process of mechanically breaking down and absorbing the nutrients in our food. And how well we are able to break down and absorb nutrients in our food are at the core of human health. Along with good bacteria and potentially bad bacteria that live in our colons, this is really at the core of human health. So digestion begins in the mouth. This is where salivary amylase starts to work on carbohydrates as soon as it enters our mouth. So as soon as we start chewing, we release a specific enzyme in our mouth, and that's why we get this blood sugar rush relatively quickly when we start to eat something with sugars in it, which is a positive thing. From there, the food moves through our esophagus into our stomachs. And actually, a lot of people, when they tell me their stomachs hurt, they usually go like this. Your stomach, believe it or not, is way up here. So that's where our food moves into. As soon as our food hits our stomach, we start to release different acids. Hydrochloric acid is one of them, and different digestive juices. These function in two ways. First of all, the hydrochloric acid starts to break down things like proteins. So we already start to absorb them in the stomach. And it also helps the small intestine know that food is on the way. So that's really cool. It gets prepared already when we already have food in our stomach. So, as we move into the small intestine, bile, which is from the gallbladder, is released. And what this does is help emulsify fats. If you've ever made a salad dressing before, you'll be familiar with this process. If you're trying to combine oil and vinegar, it doesn't work. You add a little mustard, then the fats are emulsified and everything sort of comes together. At least that's the best way I can describe it. And then the pancreas, which is over here, is an organ which produces enzymes. And it's pretty intelligent, actually. It produces enzymes specific to the foods that you're eating. So let's say you have a carrot coming through, it will produce enzymes specific to the nutrients found in that carrot. Pretty neat. So from the small intestine, we actually have the food moving into our large intestine or our colon, where any remaining water still left is squeezed out, and then the food can be eliminated. Our digestive system is at the core of our body's functioning, and what we put into that core is essential for overall health. Now, athletes actually have an increased calorie need or food need in general, and so their digestive systems are put under a little more stress than the average person. This is because we need extra carbohydrates to replenish glycogen stores and a little more protein to repair damaged muscles. So it's of the utmost importance that an athlete's digestive system is always functioning at its best. So here are some tips in order to do that. I like to break this down into three different parts. The first is actions, the second is environment, and the third is mood. So under actions, we're looking at a few things. First and foremost is chewing. The number one tip I can give to people without doing anything, without spending any money or going to the health food store, is just simply chewing. In our very busy world, we're very distracted all the time, either on our phones or computer. We're not really focusing on the food and the actual mechanics of the digestion. Because we don't have teeth in our stomach, our mouth is the only place and the only chance we have to physically break down the food. And this is really important because when we chew, we increase the surface area of the food, and so we can actually absorb or get more nutrients from it. Again, the greater the surface area of the food, the more nutrients that are available to us. So that's why chewing is so important. And as a general rule, I like to chew till it's liquid, which can be a little laborious, but again, that's why it's really important to put the phone away, even a book to distract you, really just sit and focus on the food. And saying that, it is really important to sit down while you eat. Here's why. So when we are sitting down, our muscles are pretty relaxed, at least our external limbs. We require so much blood and energy when we're digesting in the core of our body, in the center. If we're standing up, actually there's a lot of blood in our legs, and we're actually not telling our bodies that we're ready to digest or eat. And so our bodies are kind of in this state of being ready to like move anywhere we want them to. But when we sit down, we tell our bodies, now's the time to digest, so all of that blood can be shunted to the digestive system. We can actually digest our food properly, which is really important. It's also really important to eat when you're hungry instead of according to a clock. Like I mentioned before, when we eat, our stomach starts to produce all kinds of digestive juices and acids. And unless we're hungry, we will not have those things ready to rock when we need them. So when we put food in our stomachs when we're not hungry, it sort of just sits there waiting for all these things to get going. So that hunger we feel is a really good signal to tell us that our bodies are ready to receive the food and ready to digest them properly, which is so important. And the other thing I'll mention in actions is not drinking when you're eating. A little bit is fine, maybe, you know, a 6-ounce glass of water, but when we drink a lot, we actually dilute all of those really important digestive juices and our hydrochloric acid, the stomach acid. These things are essential for things like absorbing iron, also killing any kind of bacteria or parasites that come in through our food. And so drinking a lot of water will water down the digestive juices. So try and drink water 30 minutes before you eat, or an hour or two after your meal. It also will help not fill you up so much so you can eat more, which is what we all want, especially when you're an athlete. So under environment, I always encourage people to eat in a quiet, peaceful atmosphere. And this is so you're not too distracted, and again, so you're not jumping up to go do something and telling your body, or contradicting yourself, I should say. And as far as mood goes, it's a really good idea to be calm and restful when you eat. I don't know if you've heard of something called fight or flight mode, but this is just a reaction in our day-to-day lives that we have to any kind of stressors. Now, this means that when we're stressed out, we actually shunt all the blood into our limbs, and that's so we're ready to fight or we're ready to physically run away. This was just a biological part of our evolution, so that when we were faced with something, some kind of physical threat, we could either fight it or run away. But we haven't evolved past this to the point where even if we get a really bad call from our boss about something or we get a stressful email, we have the exact same reaction, even if it's not a physical threat. So that's why eating in a calm place where we're not being overly stimulated by outside influences is a good idea, because even if they're not physical threats, the blood is going to be shunted away from our core, from our digestive system, when we need it the very most. Mm-hmm.